Good morning, Sylvan. So now we are going to discuss the heating effect of electric current. Suppose we are considering the case of a conductor which is having certain amount of resistance. Like R is considered as the resistance of this conductor. So we are considering like IV, the current is passing through this conductor. So we know when a current is passing through a conductor, potential difference is developing across this conductor. That means there is a charge is flowing through this conductor. So we can calculate what is the work done to move this charge from one end to another end of this conductor. So the work done to move the charge from one end to another end of this conductor is given as what is that? W is equal to, we can say that V into Q. Where V is the potential developed across this conductor and Q is the charge which is flowing. So, we can modify this equation as work done is equal to, we know according to Ohm's law what is this work done means V into Q. So, potential we can modify it as according to Ohm's law V is equal to I into R. And similarly charge Q, so according to Ohm's law V is equal to IR we can mention. And charge Q is equal to what is coming I into T. So, Q is equal to I into T. So, we can substitute these two terms here Q into IT. So, the equation for work done is considered as I squared RT we are getting. That means, in order to moving a charge from one end to another end of this conductor, so this is work done as, so work done is equal to I squared RT, and this work done is considered as the amount of heat energy dissipated in this circuit. So, we can mention this work done as H is equal to I squared RT. So, the amount of heat energy dissipated in the case of this resistance is given by H is equal to I squared RT. So, this relation H is equal to I squared RT is known as, you know that is known as the Joule's law of heat. Joule's law of heat. So, you can see that from this equation. The amount of heat energy producing on a conductor is depends on basically three factors. What is that? H is amount of heat energy produced is directly proportional what is that? The square of the current. So we can say that it is depends on the current. And what is that? H is also depends on the resistance of the conductor. So H is directly proportional to the resistance. And also we can say that H is proportional to what is that? The time for which a current is passing through this conductor. So, this is the way the amount of heat energy producing on this conductor is depends on the current passing through the conductor, that means the square of the current, resistance of the conductor and the time for which current is passing. This equation H is equal to I squared RT is known as what is under Joule's law of heating. So, based on this we can state the Joule's law of heating. So, Joule's law of heating states that the amount of heat energy produced on a conductor is directly proportional to the square of the current, resistance of the conductor and time for which current is passing through that conductor. So this is the way we can state this Joule's law of heating. We know when we are considering the case of this Joule's law of heating, there is so many practical applications you can see that relating to our daily life situations. For example, when we are considering the case of a filament bulb. You know, in the case of a filament bulb, this filament is made up of what is that? A tungsten material. Tungsten, it's a melting point is very high, approximately it's a melting point is coming as a, what is that? 3380 degrees Celsius. Its melting point is very high, 3380 degrees Celsius. This much of high melting point is there. In the case of tungsten. I am talking about the filament bulb only. So, in that case we are using this Joule's law of heating only. You know, when a current is passing through that filament, which is having high melting point, so, and high resistivity also. So, you know, that tungsten is get heated. And gradually that heat energy only converted into what is that light energy. So, there we are applying this Joule's law of heating. Similarly, you can consider the case of another application, the case of electric fuse, you can see that. Electric fuse. In the case of a fuse, usually the fuse wire is what is that in the case of a copper we are using, aluminium we are using, or lead we are using. So this is the various types of materials we are using for making a surface well. You know, whenever excess current is passing through the surface, it's get heated. The surface is get heated because the material which we are using, the surface well, having low melting point. Low melting point. So whenever excess current is passing through this, so this fuser is getting heated and gradually it will burn and the circuit will break. So there also we are applying this Joule's law of heating in the case of electric fuse. We can see that like that way so many appliances are working in the case of electric iron or electric toaster. All these are working with the, what is that, Joule's law of heating only. So this is the way we can consider the case of Joule's law of heating. So here you are seeing that the amount of heat energy produced is considered as, what is that, H is equal to I squared R. So if you consider the amount of, that means the rate of heat energy produced, the rate of heat energy produced, that means H by T if you are considering, so that is considered as I squared R. So the rate at which the heat energy consumed is, we call it as, what is that, we call it as electric power, we can say. So electric power is represented as a P, so P is equal to I squared R. So electric power is defined as, what is that, the rate at which electric energy consumed, that is known as electric power. The rate at which electric energy consumed, so that is known as electric power, so P is equal to I squared R. So when we are considering the case of electric power, we are getting P is equal to I squared R. You can see that there are various forms of this I squared R. According to Ohm's law, we know I is equal to, what is coming? I is equal to V by R. If you are substituting this, you will get this as, what is coming? P is equal to V squared by R squared into R. V squared by R squared into R means this will cancel. Ultimately, you are getting one more another as V squared by R. So this is another form of this power, power P is equal to V squared divided by R. Similarly, we can find one more method. We can see that from this R also we can substitute. R is equal to, what is coming? V by I. V by I. So if you are substituting this value here, power is equal to, what is coming? I squared into V by I. So this will cancel ultimately. So we are getting the answer as, we are getting the answer as power is equal to VI. So this is way various forms of equation you can see that. So P is equal to I squared R, or P is equal to V squared divided by R, or P is equal to VI. So these are the various equations which is used to represent the power. So electric power means, what is that? Electrical energy consumed per unit time. The rate at which electrical energy consumed is known as electric power. And the SI unit of this electric power is considered as, what is that? Power is equal to, what is that? SI unit of electric power is considered as, what is that? Watt, we can say. Watt. SI unit of electric power is considered as a watt. Or there is some higher units also we are using. What is that? We can represent as a kilowatt. So kilowatt also we can represent. So this is where we can consider the higher units of what is that? Power, electric power. Watt or a kilowatt. Now, you can see that based on this power, we can represent the energy also. How do you represent the energy? Power is defined as electrical energy consumed per unit time. So, power is equal to, what is that? Electrical energy consumed per unit time. That means work done upon time. So based on this we can calculate energy divided by time. Work done over energy. Energy divided by time. So based on this we can write the equation of energy. Electrical energy as, what is that energy is equal to? Power into time. So power into time. That means we are getting a new formula for what is that energy. Energy is in terms of power. So power into time. So we can express this SI unit also. What is that? SI energy, we know SI unit of energy is usually we are representing joule. So in terms of this power and time, we can represent as, what is that? Watt hour. So we can represent as watt hour, or we can represent this as what is that power is considered as a watt and second, we can say watt second we can mention. So when we consider the case of a watt second is considered as a smaller unit only. So we can mention this as a what is that watt we can represent as a kilowatt, and the second we can mention as a hour. So we can mention this as a kilowatt hour, or we can represent this as a kWh. So this is considered as the commercial unit of electrical energy consumed. We can say kilowatt hour, kWh. And we can see what is the relationship between this electric power and energy. So we can consider 1 kilowatt hour is equal to how much in terms of joule. So we can see what is the relationship between SI unit and the commercial unit of energy. So you see that 1 kilowatt hour is the commercial unit of electrical energy. So if you want to express in terms of joule, you see that 1 kilo means 1 kilo means it becomes what is coming 1000 watt into hour is we know 3600 seconds. That means we can represent in this as 1 kilowatt hour is equal what is coming 3.6 × 10⁶ watt second. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to what is coming 3.6 × 10⁶ watt second is what is the joule. So we can represent. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. So this is where we can show the relationship between the commercial unit and the SI unit of energy. So 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 × 10⁶ joule. Okay.